Hey friends, this is Nirmal from NirmalTV.com, and today we'll have a quick review of the new YouTube app for Windows Phone 8 users from Microsoft. So Microsoft has released this official app for YouTube on WP8. So back in May, Microsoft had released this version 2 of the YouTube app, but then there were complaints from Google that it was violating the TOS of YouTube. Like it was allowing you to download videos, and also there were no ads displayed on the videos. So Microsoft has addressed these concerns and updated the app and re-released the app on Windows Phone Store. So let's have a quick look at the new version and see what's new in this app. So I have pinned this app to the start screen. So as soon as I open the app, I can see the recommended videos. Right now I have signed in with my ID, so it will show me the recommended videos. Then I have the subscriptions. Then you can see the trending videos. You can load more videos using the button at the bottom. And then you can browse other videos like music, sports, games, channels, movies, travels, etc. So you can browse more channels as well. And so you can use a search at the bottom, at the top. You can use a search functionality to search for videos. Then you have the option and you have the option to view your account. So click on the profile button at the top and you can see your favorites, watch later videos, history, likes, playlist, uploads and subscriptions. So here there is a new feature under uploads. You can view your uploaded videos, the videos you uploaded to your account. Then you have the option to upload a new video from the phone. This is a new feature in this app. So when I select this, it'll ask me to select the videos from my phone. Currently all the videos in my phone are listed here, so I can select a video. Say right now if I select, it'll say the file is large in size, it cannot be uploaded, so there's a file size limitation. So now let's select this video. So it is selected right now, so I can add the title for this video. Then I can add the category, and then privacy settings. Then you can upload the video. So now the video will be downloaded, uploaded based on your internet connection on your phone. So you can set these priorities from the settings. So now let's select the settings. So I set the region, our video streaming quality. You can set it to high quality or medium quality or low quality based on your internet connection. Then there is upload video over, so you can set any. This means it'll upload the video over data connections as well, you mean 3G or 4G LTE. And if I set to Wi-Fi, it'll upload only when the phone is connected to a Wi-Fi. So video hub integration is there, play under lock screen, and enable live tiles. These are the other options. And safe search, you can enable safe search. This means videos which are not included under safe search will not be available when you search. So that's other details. Then you have the option to upload videos from here as well. So the same field functionality. Now if I select a video, and let me just play a video here. Let's play one video and see. So let me just play. You can see the uploaded videos here. So you can even edit your uploaded videos. You can change the category and the title, although tags are not visible here, and tags and description cannot be edited here. Then you can update the videos here. Now let's play a video from here and see how it looks. So let me just play this video, recommended video. So you can see the details. You can see the comments. You can see the comments, related videos. Then other details on this video, the likes, the comment. You can share the video. You can pin the video to start screen. You can copy the video link, and then flag the video as inappropriate. So on the playback, you have the option to make it full screen, and under the full screen mode, you have the settings to change it to high quality or change it to low quality based on your internet connection. So those are the options available. And then this is the playback option. So overall, a very good app. There has been much of a feature reduction based on what was released back in May. Only the option to download has been removed, but you have right now you have the option to upload videos as well. So overall, this is a very good app from Microsoft, and this app is pretty good for watching YouTube videos on your Windows phone. So that's all, guys. Thanks for watching the video.
Thank you.